If you are using Lightroom CC, then odds are you probably also have Photoshop. And if you want to use Photoshop to edit your photos that you've imported into Lightroom, the best way is to go directly from Lightroom into Photoshop and then bring it back into Lightroom. Now, before you take that step with your images, you may want to check the external editing preference settings. Go into your Lightroom preferences and select external editing. At the top, you have the Adobe Photoshop options. If you are not sure what to do, you can leave everything as is and you'll be just fine. These are the recommended settings for Photoshop. But let's say you use On1 Photo, for example. On1 can read PSD files from Photoshop. It can't read all of the layers, but you can do things in Photoshop and then also do them in On1, such as mask a photo in Photoshop and then finish it in On1 or vice versa. And some of those settings, like masking, are interchangeable. If you want to do that, then you'll need to make sure that you select PSD as your option. It's going to give you a little blurb off to the right. Go ahead and read that and follow those instructions if needed. Editing a photo from Lightroom to Photoshop can be done from either the Library module or the Develop module. You can go up to Photo, Edit In, and then select Edit in Adobe Photoshop CC. The fastest way is just to use the keyboard shortcut Command or Control E. And I'll go ahead and do that right now. I'll go ahead and make a few adjustments to this image. And when I'm finished, I'll go ahead and save the file by using the keyboard shortcut Command or Control S. And when I'm finished, I just close the file. I'll go ahead and quit Photoshop as well. I'm going to jump into grid view. And now I have both of those images side by side. The Photoshop image is on the left, and the original RAW file is on the right. Let's say that I want to make some more edits to this in Photoshop. I'll do that same keyboard shortcut, Command or Control E. The top option is to edit a copy of this photo with Lightroom adjustments. Now, I didn't make any adjustments to the image, but if I had, then maybe I wanted to start over from scratch with that file inside of Photoshop. Maybe I cropped the photo, or I did some transform edits to it, whatever the case is. I can choose this option if I just want to create basically a brand new file as a copy with whatever settings I've applied inside of Lightroom. Edit a copy is just taking the original photo and making another copy of it, and then I can just edit that from inside of Photoshop, and I'll see those existing adjustments that I made with the original file. And the last option is to edit the original. This will just open up that same file that we saw inside of Photoshop. I'm going to cancel that though, because I'm going to go into the Develop module and make some changes, because I think it'll be a little bit more obvious what happens when I choose one of those options to edit the photo. I'll go into split toning and I'll just make a quick and dirty split toning. And I'm also going to add a vignette. So if I toggle this on and off, I can see the file that I edited in Photoshop. And then this has the vignette and the split toning effect that I applied inside of the Develop module. I'll select Command or Control E, and I get those options once again. Because I've made adjustments, then I could choose the top option of Edit a Copy with Lightroom Adjustments. But what if I want to make adjustments to the original edits that I created inside of Photoshop? If I choose Edit Original and click Edit, the photo opens up inside of Photoshop, but I'm not seeing any of those adjustments that I made in Lightroom. I'm going to make another edit to this so we can see some obvious changes in Lightroom once I save it and bring it back in there. I'll change it to black and white, and I'm going to save the file. I don't need to close the file in order to see the changes in Lightroom as long as I save it. So if I go back into Lightroom, I can see that I now have a desaturated version of that photo. But the split toning and vignette adjustments that I made in the Develop module are still there.